The IKEA Sladda. Once upon a time, my review of the Sladda was my most popular video, and to this day, I still get comments, even from people wanting to find one, searching in vain. And I understand the desire. I was reeled in by the Sladda. It was love at first sight. From a mass-produced product for the masses perspective, the Sladda stands out. It looks just unique enough and has just enough bells and whistles. I mean, literally, there's a bell integrated into the front brake lever. The bike won multiple design awards, including artistic style, and even I believe some for its usefulness as a utility bike, engineering awards. And it's enhanced by the available accessories, and I have most of them, the front and the rear racks. These aren't just afterthought add-ons, they're perfectly matching and engineered for easy installation and removal. Thanks to the simple design, a single hex wrench is all it takes to remove or install the rack. Both the front and the rear use the same easy mounting system. There's also a utility trailer designed for use with the Sladda, again, matching powder coat metal. It has fenders to protect whatever you're hauling, the same wood trim as the racks. It comes with its own safety flag, and even the wheels and the tires, they match those on the Sladda. It can also be used as a pull cart without the bike using the handle, or that handle converts to a tow arm with two retainer pins. And like the racks, it's easy to get on or off the bike. It has a single retainer pin, like those used on the tow arm. Very simple, very effective. Again, the well-thought-out design and the quality, it's visually there. It's easy to see, no wonder it was so popular. It was affordable too, mine only cost around $400. So with all this good and a name like IKEA backing it up, what went wrong? Only one of the most important things on a bike, the drivetrain. IKEA made two ill-fated choices for the drivetrain. First, and not long after the Sladda hit store shelves, SRAM discontinued the automatic's two-speed hub. That alone isn't enough to end the bike in my opinion. I mean, there are other internally geared rear hubs, even ones that work with a belt drive. And belt drives, they're normally bulletproof and low maintenance and give a long belt life. But the belt drive system used on the Sladda, that was the subject of a massive recall. And that recall affected dozens of bikes from countless manufacturers. And unlike the tried and proven Gates carbon drive, the Continental belt drive system, problematic enough that they pulled the plug. Now, I don't know if there were other problems with the Continental system aside from the belt itself, but a global recall on the main drive apparatus, especially on a coaster brake equipped bike, well, that was enough to doom the Sladda. And that's sad to me because everything else is so well done, quality from end to end. But quality and nice features can't save a bike from a critical design flaw. That trailer, though, it's a somewhat universal design and it can still be purchased at IKEA, so in a way, the Sladda name lives on. So they're hanging on to the name, so maybe, just maybe, one day, a new Sladda will emerge, but I wouldn't hold my breath. As for my Sladda, I don't ride it, there's no replacement belt available, plus this is the only bike I own that may have actually went up in value. I saw someone selling one online for over $1,000, and that one didn't even have the racks or the trailer. So this could be a unicorn. I mean, what do you think? Is it a collector's item or just a pile of parts getting in the way? Comment below. There's much more to come, so make sure you're subscribed and that you have the notification bell active. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.